Merci.
In sixth grade, I learned to play the tuba because our middle school marching band needed a tuba player, and I thought it was cool. Right there, that sentence should let you know that I have no idea what cool means. Playing the tuba is the least cool thing a person can do in middle and high school. The tuba itself is large, it's loud, it's obnoxious, you'll never carry the melody. It's a lot of social penalty for playing that instrument. There's another way for me to put this. Playing the tuba in high school is the most effective form of birth control that there is. So, one of my happiest days is when my tuba skills actually worked out for me. When I was a senior in high school, I applied to Penn State. I really wanted to go to Penn State for some reason. I didn't get in, but I got into one of the branch campuses. And arrogantly, I thought that Penn State made a mistake. So I called up the admissions office and I said, hi, my name is Steve Kernaghan. Could you please review my transcript? I think you made a mistake. And they did, and the admissions officer said, yes, we didn't make a mistake. You did not get in the main campus. And in this moment of desperation, I said, well, is there anything I can do to change your mind? And now that I say those words almost 20 years later, I realize it sounds like I'm trying to bribe or seduce the admissions officer, which at 17, I was ill-equipped to do both. But the admissions officer asks me, well, do you do anything? And I said, why, yes, I play the tuba. And she says, there's a way you can get into Penn State. Well, finally, I've been waiting to cash in this check for a while. So it turns out there's something called the Blue Band Exemption. So the Blue Band is the marching band at Penn State. They perform at the halftimes and the pregame. And there's something called the Blue Band Exemption where if you get accepted to a branch campus, you can then go up your senior year in the winter, try out for the Blue Band, and if you make the Blue Band, you're allowed to come to main campus. So I borrow a tuba from my high school. I practice every day for 2 months. I get the music, I schedule an audition. And in February of my senior year, my mother drives me up to Penn State for the audition. Now, I have to teach you something about brass instruments. Because if you play a brass instrument, every time you play a brass instrument, you're spitting into the instrument. It's the way it happens. You have to, the vibration of your lips is what causes the sound to come out of the instrument. So you do this, and that becomes music. It's a miracle. And so, whether it's a trumpet, a trombone, a tuba, French horn, you're spitting into the instrument, so all of these brass instruments, they have spit valves to empty the spit. The bigger the instrument, the more spit. So, I get to the audition, and they put me in a practice room, and they say, okay, you have 20 minutes to warm up, is that enough? I say, sure. I go in there, I unpack my tuba, and I start to warm up, and I realize that my tuba is filled with spit. And there's nothing I can do about it. I spend the next 15 minutes trying to get the spit out. The spit valve won't work, all the slides, they won't budge. I twist the tuba, I turn the tuba. The tuba's not helping me out. And so with my final 5 minutes, I go, okay, I'm gonna warm up on this spit-filled tuba. So in walks Dr. Richard Bundy, the director of the Blue Band, and he says, Steve, are you ready? And I lie and say yes. And he says, okay, can you play just start with a B-flat scale. So I do. Bump, 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 gurgle. And he says, whoa, you gotta stop. And I go, yeah. And he goes, can you do anything about that spit? And I said, I've been trying. I can't get the spit out of the tuba. And so he points to this massive, beautiful marching sousaphone that's sitting right next to me. It's huge. He says, well, why don't you play on one of our tubas? And I look at this tuba and I realize that it's twice the size of the tuba that I've been practicing on for the past 2 months. It's too much air. I'm not used to it. And so I say, I'd rather try out on my tuba, the one that's filled with spit and gurgles every time I hit the third valve. And Dr. Bundy shrugs, and I proceed to have the worst audition that's ever happened in the history of auditions. I gurgle through the scales. I gurgle through the sight reading. I gurgle through the audition piece that I worked 2 months on. It was awful. At the end, Dr. Bundy politely says, good job. You should get a letter from us within the week with our response. I say, thank you, I'm devastated. I get in the car, my mom says, how'd it go? I go, it was awful, it was a waste of my time. So a week later, there's an envelope waiting for me at home from the office of the Blue Band, and it says, congratulations, you made it in the blue band, you get to come to Penn State main campus. So finally, after years of playing tuba, it pays off. Now, I learned two very important things about myself at that moment. Number one, I learned supply and demand. Penn State needed tuba, I am tuba. I get to go to Penn State. But the second thing I learned, which is more important, is it takes a special type of person to play tuba. Anyone can do sports. Anyone can play basketball or run track. But it's a specific type of person that says, hey, what am I gonna get teased for like 12 years? Yeah, I'm gonna stick with this. So the next time you see a high school tuba player, you're looking at the bravest person you've ever seen. The few, the proud, the tuba. Thank you very much. Thank you. Oh, thank you.